and compare the observations made in one frame of reference with the other frame of reference, isn't it? So let us now write down and try to get a formula which converts observations made in one frame to the frame. So we have what is known as Galilean transformations. Okay, they are very important. They actually are very simple, but this is a very important transformation. Let us think of a situation where our friend, the black observer, he is watching the ball. In the case earlier slide, the ball was at rest. Now what's happening? The ball is moving. As the ball is moving, can you see the clock is moving?
Yes.
In different times, ball is occupying different positions. There is a stopwatch showing the lapse of time, and there is an invisible magic pen that at every full second marks x coordinates of the ball. This pen you are not able to see, but it is marking. Isn't it? What is the situation about? What are we talking about? What we can do is, black observer is watched by the blue observer. Earlier I just showed you only this. He is moving. Now this moving is observed from here. Now the question is, are the ball position coordinates the same in the blue observer's frame as is measured in the black observer's frame? Is the ball speed seen by both observers the same or not? Is it the same? What do you observe? Blue observer is observing a black observer moving. He is making a coordinates measurement. He is also making a velocity measurement. Are they the same in both the frames of reference or not? Yes or no? How many of you say yes? Are measurements the same? No? How many of you say no? All of you are saying no. Do any one of you say yes? Nobody says yes. Let us. They are not the same. They are not the same. Is the speed the same?
Yes.
It's moving to the same?
Yes.
Now let us see how we. Can you see the clock? Black observer is the same, but sees exactly the same ball motion as before. The entire frame is now moving with a constant speed in which direction? X direction. Let us observe the motion only in one direction for the present. We can explain it in Y and Z axis also, but the present is moving only in the X direction. The position of the bar dot in the blue frame at every full second is marked by red tick. And the position of the moving frame's origin is marked by a blue tick. At some points they are coinciding, at some points they are not. That you observe? Okay? So what is it? What does it mean? The distance between the two black marks represents the velocity of the black frame relative to the blue frame. This is known as translational velocity. We call it as U. The frame is moving with one velocity. The difference in the velocity measurement made by blue frame of reference and black frame of reference is known as, what is that velocity? Translational velocity. And the distance between the two red marks on the blue axis represents the ball velocity in the blue frame, and we call it as. So, ball's velocity in the black frame is V prime. So, what was the formula we got is in the last
R prime
is equal to R minus R. R plus R dash is R. R plus R dash. What is R? This plus, that means this frame of reference plus this frame of reference is equal to. So use that relation.